Hello, this is Echoing Clock.
And Ripper95, a.k.a. CoolGuy902, and we have shifted controls from Echoing Clock to me today, because EC over here cannot do this minigame to save his life.
There are two types of good fish to catch. 1 pound fishies and 5 pound fishies. If you miss 20 pounds of good fish, then I'm gonna take me net back from you.
But we could just ask for
there are poisonous eels in this river. Catch even a one of them boogers, and you'll poison the whole darn catch.
Now, last episode we talked to the fisherman, and he said to us that if we could help him out with catching some fish, then he'll lend us the boat so we can get back to Misty Island. So, the premise of this is, yeah, he explained there's the 1 pound green fish and the 5 pound yellow fish. If you miss one yellow fish, it counts as missing five of the green fish. You want to avoid the eels because just accidentally catching one of those and you have to start over. Odds are this will take you a few tries, but not only does he give you a power cell at the end, but he also lets you take the boat to Misty Island, which unlocks the whole area of Misty Island for exploration, the collection of collectibles, and so on and so forth. And he also tells you when, normally he tells you when a yellow fish is coming in a stream of green fish, so that's another way that he makes it a little bit easier for you. Oh, jeez. Oh my god. And as you can see, the eels come in packs.
Oh god.
That was not good. As you see, I just screwed up there big time by missing a yellow fish. But now, here comes an onslaught of green fish.
You caught 200 pounds of fish.
And now we shift controls back.
For a couple of landlubbers. Here's the power cell I promised. And you can use my boat at the village dock whenever you like.
Now that's one of, I think, two or three mini games are in the game. Let's see, there's one in the next area. There's this one. And then there's. Two and three, they get really big onto the mini games, and some of them get kind of ridiculous, like a Pac-Man remake.
That was a mini game that was kind of into the story.
Yeah, which was kind of sad. Or the Whack-A-Mole mini game. Remember that one?
Yeah, I remember that. We're sorry if we're sort of like giving away the premise of the mini games that are in later games, but yeah,
we don't really care.
They're just mini games. They really don't affect the story. Well, they do in a certain context, but we're not giving away the story. So, as you can see, there's more these orbs. If I go too far into the water, the shark's in there too.
Maybe that's why it's forbidden.
Maybe that's why it's forbidden. Maybe it's also because there's a giant temple. Maybe that's like it's a sacred temple.
Oh, maybe. Who knows?
So you know what? The first thing I'd like to do is get this blue eco and see what that pad there that looks like has like air coming out. Oh,
and blue eco charge door. In our original take of this, we failed 3 times getting this.
Yep. But as you can see, once you try it a few times, it gets kind of easy. So like, maybe on your third or fourth play through the game, you'll be able to do it without even sweating about it. Like, you'll be able to like, just walk up to it and be like, oh hey, open it for me.
Let's get up on that machine and break the mirror diverting the precursor beam.
You think, Daxter?
Oh, and that's...
Ooh. Oh, first death of the game, and... Oh,
I'll say second something death. Really teary at the funeral.
Well, second death.
How am I gonna get Shane back now?
Now, normally when you die on land like that, Daxter makes you kind of smarmy remark. Like that, like, how am I gonna get Shane back now at your funeral?
As you can see, he cares more about himself than his own friendships. didn't do it.
You sure you didn't do it? Because I think you
maybe
did.
It was one of the spike things I'm trying to dodge. Maybe it was the piranha. Were you swimming in the water?
Oh, must have been a piranha. Sorry if some of our commentary gets a little dull. Jak 1 is a moderately hard game to commentate over because there's not much to this game as much as there is to the second and third game. We'll be able to commentate a lot more later on in the story, but as for now, it's just kind of punch and jump.
And break mirrors.
You done floated in their tour.
Let's go fiddle with them.
Fiddle the toys we broke?
No, the other toys that we haven't broken. Can he make it, folks? Can he make it? He made it.
Alright. So.
Now, something that we haven't addressed yet is. Samus said that, Samus is a different character, a different game entirely, much more attractive.
Samus is the chick you play in Metroid.
Yes, Samus is that. That's who Samus is. Now, something Samus, addressed earlier on is that smaller balls of Eco, Green Eco, put together will make a large cluster, which you can use to regain health. Well, getting 50 small balls of eco, as we're about to demonstrate here, will recharge one of your heart pieces. If you have a full heart and you get and you get 50 small pieces of green eco, you essentially get a fourth hit.
You see what I just did there? I just jumped across here and spat and grabbed off this. I just actually jumped off.
Yeah.
Another thing is if you roll jump, it's a much farther jump. So keep that in mind. If you're trying to go the distance.
I see what you did there. Apparently he just cracks himself up.
So he's gonna keep laughing for the rest of the game. So, even when you come back to visit him later, he'll still be laughing his head off.
Which kind of worries me.
It's not like he leaves to give his fish to people or sell them or anything. He just keeps laughing.
He just keeps laughing at 200 pounds of rotten fish. Which I don't think is normal.
So, as you can see, there's another thing that looks like it could be reactivated with Blue Eco. So, I'm going to break the plates. Kill the regenerating plant. Yes, it does regenerate no matter how many times you kill it. It will come back to haunt you.
Hey guys, can I be in your movie? No, plant, get out of here.
Oh, I'm a failure.
And he finally takes hold of it.
So actually, I can just rush around here. Not that big of a deal. I'm right back here again. So that opens the door. So what a lot of people do, they like to go that way and go up there. But I'd like to go this way.
Because he's a rebel and a hipster. Well, primarily a hipster.
Because there's that there. That's a sixth of them. Which means there's probably one more somewhere. This activates this, it brings me up. Another one.
Let's see if you can make it with one continuous loop of eco. I don't think you can make it.
Yeah, I'm not gonna make it.
Oh, you were
and
so
as you can see,
funny.
That blue eco, it activates two of them. Now, if you see here, that's another piece of blue eco that just breaks with the piston. And that's the seventh scout find.
High five!
That's the last of the scout flies in this level. I'm gonna charge.
Right.
Oh, and
found
I did it.
All the scout flies in this area.
Thank you, Daxter. We did not know that because we just got a power cell for it.
So, as you see, there's three parts that can be activated by one piece of Blue Eco. So, Blue Eco doesn't just charge up your body and make you move faster, but it opens multiple pieces of.
And what's this?
Thing at a time.
The obligatory. Oh, hey, you reached the highest point in this section of the map. A collectible, not achievement, because we are.
And as you can see from here, that's a dirigible.
Oh my. Dirigible. There's no D after the D at the beginning.
Dirigible. I'm sorry.
So help me, I will get you to learn that word. By the end of this Let's Play, I will make you learn something.
So yeah. As I'm sure we've said, this is a seamless 3D game, so...
That's the reason why it has to give
so
you a top only view.
Here, but yeah. You aren't powered up with the blue stuff.
So and that in the perspective would be kind of thrown out of whack due to the camera controls that are, in my opinion, not the best camera controls on the PlayStation 2 game of all time, but, you know, you can't really complain too much about them.
So this game got an award for the first seamless 3D game,
which I specified for the first or second episode.
Jak 2 got most
cutscenes in a single game, which was then replaced by its successor, Jak 3, which had 231 total cutscenes, which amounts to most of the game's length.
So this is, looks like a whole bunch of electricity. So I'm just gonna walk in this metal with electricity coming out of it.
Cause that's safe, kids. If you ever see electricity somewhere, make sure you stand on the closest bit of metal touching it.
And as you can see, it's really blue eco. It's not real electricity. But if there's really electricity coming out of stuff, throw some on it.
It looks like that thing in Halo that really have to be a tryhard to get. Oh, my, what is it all? Bad weather or something? Stupid stuff like that.
Yeah,
something
like that. So,
inclement weather, that's it.
Inclement weather, that's right. So we're going to call that an episode. We'll see you later. This has been Echoing Clock
and Ripper95, a.k.a. Cool Guy 902.
Bye.
See ya.